Underwater cave reveals new treasure location? Rick and Marty Lagina are checking renovations in a historical structure called the Garden Shaft in the Money Pit area. They're about to inspect it for the first time this year. Before they get ready, Rick explains a water issue at the bottom of the shaft, particularly at set 16. Roger assures them it's not undermining the structure, but they need to stop or contain it. They discuss plans, get dressed, and head down. The team is concerned about water infiltration, which has been a problem for over 200 years. They acknowledge it's a puzzling issue concentrated in one area. Roger is reassured that it's not undermining the shaft. They plan to stop or contain the water, considering the bottom of the garden shaft as crucial to solving the mystery. Duma's Contracting Limited worked on renovations for 3 weeks, extending the shaft from 82 feet to 87 feet, aiming for a total depth of nearly 100 feet. The Oak Island team aims to breach a mysterious 70-foot-high tunnel discovered during core drilling. The tunnel, carbon dated to the 17th century, runs from east to west towards the Baby Blob, an area with high concentrations of gold, silver, and metals in groundwater between depths of 80 and 20 feet. The team is cautious and wants to understand what's happening in the shaft. There's a water issue that they need to address. They plan to go one set above where the water starts, punch 9 holes, and use fast-setting urethane to stop the water infiltration. The plan is to use urethane to seal off the water. A specialized compound, similar to expanding foam, will be applied under pressure to seal a crack and potentially stop water intrusion completely. Rick, having landed, asks Roger about their current depth compared to last year. Roger explains they are about 4 feet lower, currently at 87 feet from the top. Rick expresses excitement about seeing unseen dirt and mentions being close to the mysterious tunnel they hope to find. Roger opens a hatch to show the dirt, emphasizing the significance of exploring it during pro-drilling. The team hopes to discover the unknown tunnel, and apart from artifact recovery, find valuable resources like gold and silver. The main importance lies in locating the horizontal drill. If the team discovers the believed tunnel below, Dumas can use a probe drilling device to search for valuable evidence up to 40 feet in every direction. If the existing tunnel is not accessible, Dumas has the option to construct a new tunnel to reach any important clues found during this process. As Dumas continues work on the garden shaft, geologist Terry Matt and archaeologist Moya McDonald supervise core drilling in borehole KL-14.5. The borehole is set to penetrate the center of Aladdin's cave, almost 150 feet underground. During the core drilling operation, the team uses the Anton Spectrum 120 high-definition camera to explore a massive cavern. This camera is designed to work in low light and water, providing a 360 degrees view as it pans and tilts. Their goal is to find evidence that humans excavated the cave. As they drill, they reach around 142 at the top of the casing, believing they are inside the cave. They notice the silt moving and discover a square object that appears man-made, like a square-headed bolt. Finding such evidence is crucial in Aladdin's cave. However, they acknowledge the need for further investigation. They consider sending a miniature gharry down to detect and explore the cave's bottom. They try to understand the surroundings, looking for any man-made objects that could be significant to the island's history. Despite challenges with sediment and shadows, they manage to see interesting details. They observe a current and conclude that the cave seems wide open, though obscured by silt. Recognizing the importance of the discovery, they plan to use sonar in a few days to map the cave's dimensions, openings, and underground structure. The team expresses excitement, seeing this as a potential treasure location. They decide to reconfigure and prepare for further exploration using sonar. Aladdin's cave reveals man-made workings. In the Money Pit area of Oak Island, the team, led by Rick and Marty, recently acquired new sonar data revealing potential man-made structures approximately 150 feet deep within Aladdin's cave, a sizable cavern. The team, including members like Steve and Paul, is intrigued by the findings, emphasizing their unnatural appearance. Steve plans to incorporate the sonar data into a 3D model for better analysis. Paul notes the significance of characterizing the cave's opening, believing it can provide valuable insights into historical digging and activity beneath 106 in the Money Pit area. As Paul rotates the model, the team eagerly anticipates gaining more information. Amidst dramatic music, the team observes the 3D representation, pausing on specific details. Terry suggests the possibility of a sand slope that may be covering potential artifacts or structures on the cave floor. Marty points out a square wall along one side, describing it as very interesting. The team speculates that the presence of man-made structures in the cave could be linked to a historical deposit of treasure. The team intensifies their exploration, particularly focusing on the western part of the cave. Marty stresses the importance of understanding where the structures come from. The data suggests the cave is quite large, heightening the team's excitement. The prevalent belief is that the man-made elements in the cave may be linked to a valuable treasure. Marty asks if there's a potential entrance to explore, suggesting heading in a certain direction. He emphasizes the need to drill a hole to investigate further. Rick agrees, expressing the desire to find a way into Aladdin's cave. Considering the possibility of hidden treasure, he acknowledges the incremental nature of Oak Island discoveries, suggesting more drilling to assess the situation. The team agrees on the plan, conducting additional drilling and using a camera to gather more information before deciding how to proceed. They stress the importance of making a thorough assessment. The team leans towards a more detailed outward-looking scan for the next drill hole. The next day, problems arise during drilling, causing worry. Scott encounters difficulties in the shaft wall while trying to find where water is coming in. The team encounters challenges in their attempt to reveal the mysteries concealed within Aladdin's cave. Scott shares alarming details about the water inflow rate, noting it's rising about a foot per hour in the shaft. Roger, equipped with a camera, plans to capture pictures and videos of the situation for further analysis. Rick Lagina and Craig Tester join Scott in the Money Pit area, where Dumas Contracting Limited is working to address the persistent water flow in the garden shaft. Roger, part of the team, provides updates and shares concerning observations during the exploration. The team discovers a specific spot about 65 feet down where water is entering, and it seems isolated as other drilled areas remain dry. Roger reveals a peculiar find, a small cavern filled with timber. He shares images showing planks stacked in an unusual manner, resembling 1x6 boards. The team expresses surprise at this unexpected discovery. The team, led by Rick Lagina and Craig Tester, faces a puzzling situation in the Money Pit area. As workers from Dumas Contracting Limited conduct probe drilling to locate the source of flooding in the garden shaft, they unexpectedly discover a mysterious cavern outside the structure at a depth of 65 feet, filled with wooden timbers. The team observes the cavity, raising questions about its connection to an offset chamber or an unknown void or tunnel. Rick expresses the need to investigate further by enlarging the hole to see inside. However, the primary concern remains addressing the water flow before exploring the potential breakthrough discovery. The question of whether this setback could lead to a significant discovery that aids in unraveling the Oak Island mystery. Despite the frustration, the team acknowledges the historical continuity of dealing with water issues on the island for over 200 years. Rick emphasizes the team's determination, stating that the tunnel is still down there and they will find a way to proceed. The team expresses unity in facing challenges and solving the mystery together. Craig appreciates the plan, and Roger reassures them of their collective efforts to move forward. The mysterious stone road gives clues. In the southern part of the Oak Island swamp, Marty Lagina and Craig Tester, along with Rick Lagina and the rest of the team, are examining a wooden structure recently uncovered beneath a stone road. Rick is questioning the endpoint, pointing out two logs beneath the edge that seem carefully joined, like in cabin construction. There is brush under the structure and smaller logs supporting the road, which abruptly stops. Jack confirms the presence of swamp muck and bigger logs running perpendicular to the road, indicating they were placed during road construction. Rick notes significant timbers beneath the stone road, emphasizing the massive effort involved. He believes the road was intentionally hidden, possibly leading to a hidden treasure. As they approach the road's end, Gary shares that they once found artifacts there, including old-looking and unique chains. Rick expresses excitement over these findings, hinting at the possibility of uncovering valuable treasures. 2 weeks ago, the Oak Island team found a big, handmade chain and hook at the southern edge of a 500-year-old stone road. Blacksmith Carmen Legg said it's from the 16th century. They wonder if it was used in the swamp to move cargo from a ship to Oak Island. The chain has three or maybe four hitch points, and it seems hand-forged. The team discusses how the chain could have been used to unload heavy items onto the stable road surface. They consider the possibility of pulling something across the tough ground to the bog and up the road using a three-point hitch. Rick emphasizes how crucial the discovery is, stating that they've clearly outlined the road's extent and its transition to the beach. He speculates about a larger ship offshore, envisioning a tender bringing materials to a slipway, wharf, or dock. Rick hopes these findings will help unravel a story and provide a date. The team agrees, expressing their interest in how all the discovered items may connect and contribute to their understanding of Oak Island's history. As they discuss what's next, they plan to keep digging, particularly underneath where Billy is located. They anticipate that the best part of the excavation is yet to come, and they're determined to get it done. Marty and Gary lead the excavation with high hopes. During their search, they discover what seems to be a barrel stave. Gary notices its similarity to barrel staves previously found in the swamp. Marty speculates it's indeed a barrel stave, considering its width differences. They discuss comparing it to others nearby to check if it aligns with the idea of the area being used for unloading cargo, given that barrels were likely utilized for transporting goods. The team wonders if the barrel stave is connected to the stone road or a ship's wharf. They consider Gary's suggestion that it might be related to wooden cargo barrels unearthed 3 years ago, believed by Carmen Legg to be potentially 600 years old. Marty expresses the consistent discovery of items whenever they dig in and around the swamp, mentioning the stone road, paved area, and ramp, along with various artifacts. Eager to find more, he mentions the possibility of discovering coins. As they dig further, the team encounters an obstacle, and Gary wonders if it's wood or rocks causing the obstruction. The equipment catches on something, and they find a boulder. Uncertain if this signifies the end of the road, they contemplate doing some shoveling work to investigate. Billy gives the go-ahead, and Gary, along with Marty, decides to inspect the area to determine the nature of the obstruction. Billy directs them to the left, and Gary questions if there might be a road since it's their first pass. Marty suggests the possibility of alignment with the stone road based on the first two big rocks, but emphasizes the need to dig further. Gary considers these rocks to be retaining rocks forming the edge. Marty reflects on the significance of the stone road, seeing it as a massive construction with a special purpose. He expresses curiosity about its purpose and hopes the ongoing excavation will lead them to the answers they've been seeking for years. Marty encourages Billy to look for similar rocks as he progresses. As Gary starts the pump, Marty checks the spoils with dramatic music playing. Gary expresses excitement about the potential discoveries in the swamp. They find three pieces of wood and wonder if they could be barrel staves. One piece resembles a handle with rounded edges, leading to discussions about its possible use as an old pickaxe or axe handle, suggesting it might be hand-shaped. There is a possibility of the hand-shaped tool being used in the original construction of the stone road. There's curiosity about whether scientific analysis can reveal its age and provide insight into who brought it to Oak Island. After a brief pause, they resumed work, identifying more rocks in the area. Billy points out the arrangement of rocks, and Marty and Gary decide to investigate further. Marty acknowledges the presence of clues in the swamp, admitting to underestimating its significance previously. Marty notes the steady row of rocks and suggests there might be buried ones in between. He acknowledges being wrong about the extent of work in the swamp, expressing confidence in finding good stuff. Gary observes Marty's growing appreciation for the swamp, despite his initial reluctance. There's uncertainty about whether the rocks signify the end of the road, and they decide to involve Rick and Craig in the decision-making process. Billy suggests having the team examine the area, emphasizing its potential importance. Marty agrees to discuss it with Rick and Craig to determine the next steps, with Gary expressing confidence that they are onto something significant. The treasure hunters are still on their quest on Oak Island. They found several clues and artifacts in the past that have gotten them a step closer to uncovering the island's secrets. However, their recent findings have given the quest clearer prospects than ever before. What are these new finds? Ancient ceramic treasures unearthed. On Oak Island, as a new day begins, Rick and Marty Lagina, along with their team, are determined to unravel a 229-year-old treasure mystery. Their focus is on the triangle-shaped swamp, a challenging location spanning 140 acres. Gary, a key team member, is assigned a task. As they delve into their mission, they come across a potentially 500-year-old stone road or ship's wharf, previously discovered in 2020 in the southeast corner of the brackish bog. During recent excavations, the team stumbles upon a significant find, a large hand-wrought chain and hook. Blacksmithing expert Carmen Legge analyzes the discovery, revealing that it was not only used for lifting heavy cargo, but could also date back to the 16th century. With the excitement of this revelation, the team intensifies their efforts by digging into the southern shore bordering the swamp. Their goal is to uncover more of the stone road and gather clues that might provide evidence regarding whether the swamp was deliberately created to hide a valuable secret on Oak Island. During the excavation, the team makes interesting discoveries like an old stick and a potential stud in the ground. Billy carefully collects these items. They also observe unique layers in the soil, transitioning from peaty soil to mud. Rick suggests involving Dr. Spooner for a more detailed examination of what lies beneath. Rick notes that the X-cut wood found is intriguing as it represents an older type of wood construction. The layered composition of the soil with sand and peat raises questions about its natural origin. The team decides to continue digging. Rick and the team are digging at an excavation site. As they continue, they come across stacked rocks, and Rick thinks they might have reached the end of their digging. However, their excitement kicks in when they uncover a piece of pottery using machinery. Rick suggests hand digging to preserve the context of the findings and looks for any marks on the pottery. The team is thrilled with the discovery, emphasizing the importance of finding items in situ, in their original position. They find various pottery pieces and discuss their potential decorations and age. Rick and Gary notice distinctive features on the pottery, speculating about their significance and age. Rick and Gary are really excited about the cool designs on the pottery they found. They think that some of the pottery might be older than the rest. Gary mentions that they found different types of pottery and a couple of vessels that could be put back together. Overall, they're happy with the discoveries. Critical evidence found in wooden structure. Rick and Alex Lagina, along with metal detection expert Gary Drayton, are at the south shore of the swamp to dig and explore the stone road. After pumping out 3 million gallons of water from the swamp, they are excited to investigate the stone road once again. Billy Gerhardt, who is with them, expresses hope of finding valuable items during the dig. As Billy starts scraping gravel, Gary Drayton scans the excavated material for important clues or evidence of valuables. Rick mentions the possibility of discovering features under the swamp road that could explain why the stone road was built. The team is eager to gather as much information as possible from the swamp to contribute to solving the mystery. During the dig, Rick and the team make an interesting discovery, what appears to be a dowel. Rick connects it to the dowels found in a U-shaped structure, noting their similarity in size. They also notice a log and a peg in the vicinity. This discovery prompts further investigation and speculation about its significance in relation to the mystery they are trying to unravel. In 2018, Rick, Marty, and their team discover a mysterious feature at Smith's Cove on Oak Island. This feature was originally found by Dan Blankenship in 1971. It turns out to be a nearly 65-foot-long U-shaped wooden structure associated with flood tunnels connected to the money pit. The structure has large wooden dowels and is engraved with Roman numerals, specifically VIII. The Roman numerals match those found on an ancient musket artifact discovered 6 weeks earlier in a circular depression on Lot 5. The team notices cut marks on the structure and decides to wash and examine it further. This discovery raises the question of whether the Oak Island team has found evidence of a related wooden structure near the stone road in the swamp. If so, could it be a crucial piece of evidence to solve the Oak Island mystery? The team continues to dig and looks for more evidence in the swamp. They discuss the significance of finding another wooden construction using the same technique as the U-shaped structure. They also use a metal detector and locate a signal, discovering some kind of chain buried in the swamp. The investigation continues as they explore the possibility of uncovering more valuable clues in their quest to unravel the mysteries of Oak Island. Rick Lagina and the Oak Island team have just found something important. It's an old-looking hand-forged iron chain, and they're excited about its potential significance. Gary Drayton, the metal detection expert, thinks it looks like it predates modern forges, making it even more interesting. As they examine the chain, they speculate about its use. Rick and Gary discuss the possibility that it might have been used to unload valuable cargo from a ship onto Oak Island many years ago. They consider the idea that it could be connected to the potentially 500-year-old stone road nearby. During their search, the team discovers more items, including a hook that looks quite old and crude. They express excitement about these artifacts, suggesting that the chain may have broken while hauling something heavy, and there could be more valuable items waiting to be uncovered in their excavation. Overall, the findings hint at the possibility of significant historical activities on Oak Island, involving the movement of heavy objects and indicating the extensive work done on the island in the past. Four coins tied to the Knights Templar. Not long after exploring Lot 5, they came across four coins closely together. The amount of money that could fit into this little field is astonishing, and it calls for further investigation into how they arrived here. Some speculate that these coins are the remnants of an even more significant treasure hoard associated with the Knights Templar. In simpler terms, how can one come across even four coins at such a small distance? What does this hint at? The involvement with the Knight Temple still raises debates, as the team speculates if something is more under their land. Though there's convincing evidence by circumstances, conclusiveness still defies it. Well, something like that at least was spilt out to the public. As they continued serving, Gary found a prehistoric lead barter token. The scallop sides of this artifact have high historical value and are very similar to the Smith's Cove lead cross discovered in 2017. These lead artifacts belong to civilizations as old as the 14th century. Indeed, this corresponds to the hypothesis that the Knights Templars, a medieval order known for its wealth and mysterious rituals, could have been connected to the mystery of Oak Island. At first sight, the coins are ordinary, but scrutiny reveals an elaborately designed pattern which may be made up of symbols and signs. Thus, this interesting finding led the group to consult an eminent numismatist, Sandy Campbell, to provide insight into these coins. Sandy's team, with over 40 years of experience in ancient and scarce coin analysis, is confident Sandy's insights will solve the riddle that emanated at Lot 5 earlier this week. It would not be easy to assume that chance led to this immense discovery of five coins, for it would have been an intentional act or event. Knowing such issues, Sandy could know what is inside those coins. Sandy's team, consisting of experienced numismatists and researchers, also made many successful analyses for some obscure or complex types of coins. Together, they cover various numismatic areas like metallurgy, iconography, paleography, and provenance analyses. Such careful examination of the coin's design, materials, and method of minting is sure to yield important insights regarding their provenance. A keen inspection of any available historical documents or numismatic databases will be undertaken to establish if they hint at anything regarding their circulation characteristics and associations with particular civilizations or ages. The endgame of this team has been established, finding where the coins have come from and knowing the history behind them. Knowing where the coins come from and when they were used gives more insight into what they meant historically. Her understanding of ancient artifacts and the location where they were discovered would go a long way in answering the questions surrounding these coins. This would help unravel more information and clues to support their research as a team. She may be able to crack the mystery behind the background of these coins and their importance if she is keen on details and connecting disjointed bits of information. Her competence, combined with the knowledge of these numismatists, can reveal the coin's mystery. Sandy studies the coin very closely and notices writing on it and some settings. She stops for a while and then admits that it's an Indian coin produced between the 6th and 8th century AD. Furthermore, this discovery adds a different twist to an already puzzling assortment of coins. A coin believed to have originated from India ends up in Oak Island, among so many other coins from different parts of Europe, and this question is what leaves the team members puzzled. However, there is also English plunder, Spanish treasure, and even Chinese gold, which makes the riddle more complex. Amidst this financial chaos, Sandy makes a groundbreaking discovery, a small piece of gold hidden in one of the coins. Intricate designs inscribed onto its surface authenticate its realness as a Roman blaze. The discovery adds another Roman coin to the collection, thus doubling the team's fortune. Upon looking at the new coin, they see the face of a man with a pointed chin and a curious nose. They turn the coin and find it has two figures in an embrace, which could be dated before BC. Sandy, without any doubt, professes that this is the biggest coin ever found at Oak Island. The mysterious Oak Island, a tiny islet located along the Nova Scotia shore, has fascinated the minds of treasure seekers and history lovers for centuries. The island's beauty comes from the combination of interesting hints, such as the money pit, a deep hole people believe is loaded with gold. In this maze of mystery, the finding of three Roman coins in Lot 5 has given rise to further suspense. The investigation at Oak Island has indeed been greatly influenced by these ancient artifacts that are thought to have been manufactured more than 2,000 years ago. 17th century French relic. Rick Lagina and his colleague Gary Drayton, experienced detectives in the island's secrets, are on a trail. Lot 5's reputation as a gateway to the past is further strengthened by these numismatic wonders, three of which are believed to be around 500 AD 300. However, they meet an abnormality when they get deeper, a strap with a bow tie design. He holds the specimen, examines it carefully, and reveals that the strap is French. It is ornamental and was once placed on wooden chests with earlier French influence implied. This revelation opens a Pandora's box of possibilities. Would this then prove that the French were there before the 17th century? The connection gets even stronger when Rick says the lead cross was found to have come from the south of France. The puzzle pieces are coming together, pointing to an ancient French connection no one would have ever expected. Zena Halbern's map is another controversial document that only fuels the fire. It is a map supposedly drawn by the Knights Templar between the 12th and 14th centuries, showing a possibility of a hatch on Oak Island. While controversial, Zena's theory correlates with these new findings, implying that the Templars could have visited the island on multiple occasions to hide their secrets. The deeper the team digs, the more iron artifacts come upon them. Fasteners, tools, and even a thick-looking chisel-shaped object. Each of these findings wears the stamp of age, supporting the theory that there was a pre-money pit presence. The Lot 5 journey is still ongoing. For Rick, it is a call to action to go back there and dig more. Whenever the archaeologists reveal a discovery, the curtain of Oak Island's ancient past lifts, telling tales of French conspiracy and, of course, the Knights Templar.
With our Happy Rick Tough phone case, you can discover a whole new level of protection and style for your phone. Click on your screen or check out the first link in the description to join in on the excitement and grab your Happy Rick Tough phone case today.
Thanks for watching. While you're still here, make sure to click the video on your screen for more mind-blowing videos.